Look what just arrived. I ordered this 3D printer a few days back from Amazon and it's already here. 3D prototyping machines at one point were rare to find. I remember we had just one machine in NID and it was very difficult to access it. I wanted to get one for me for a while now, but earlier they were expensive and complicated to operate. Over the years, the technology has become more efficient, affordable, and easy to use. Hi guys, I am Yogesh Chaudhary. Welcome back to my channel Design Yogi. In this episode, we are going to unbox and print with ANet ET4. ANet has been around for a while now and offers various 3D printers. But this particular model I thought was perfect for a beginner like myself as it's priced well and is loaded with features. Features that really stood out to me other than the build volume area were heated bed, power failure resume option, which is a must if you live in a city like Gurgaon. Auto leveling option. Also, it is a semi-assembled printer compared to other printers available in this price bracket. For me, that was a huge plus. Priced at 17,499 rupees on Amazon is quite a bargain considering all the things this little gadget can do for you. The reason why I bought this 3D printer is a new project that I'm working on, which requires hundreds of small modules like these. I prefer to outsource more stuff like this, but in this case, buying a 3D printer and printing these myself is not only cost effective, but also so exciting. What these are and how I am planning to use these, more on that coming in another video very soon. If that is something you would like to watch, then I suggest you subscribe to my channel and press the ring icon to turn on the notification. The printer came in this box here, as you can see. I cannot wait to open the box. Shall we? You can see that it is a semi-assembled printer. On the top, we have these various packets with hardware components, a conveyor belt, some nuts, PLA filament, a micro SD card with the USB drive, a nozzle and a fuse, instructions manual, and some tools that will help us put it all together. This, I think, is the top half of the printer. And this is the print head. So at the bottom of the box, we have the base of the printer with a glass bed. Few more things in the box, a power cable, and the filament spool holder. Here it is, all assembled and ready for printing. But before we can start the print, we need to load in the filament. I also ordered 101 kg PLA filament with the printer also from Amazon. It costed me 1250 rupees. I was looking for a bright and saturated color and decided on this purple to test for the first few prints. Micro SD card provided with the printer comes with 3 preloaded models for you to start printing right away. You can also Google and download ready-to-print files available online on various websites for free. I am going to now insert the SD card into this printer and we are ready to print. No, wait. The final and the most important step is to level the print bed. If the print bed is not properly leveled, then the filament won't stick properly to the surface, eventually spoiling your print. I am going to use the auto level feature and hopefully that will do the job. If not, then we would have to manually level the bed. Once the bed is leveled, I can go ahead and press print. And here we go, it's finally printing. it's very cold in Gurgaon right now, and probably that's the reason why the model is coming off again and again. It is a good thing in a way, because mostly the issue comes in taking the model out from the bed. And that is why these days most printers come with a glass bed like this. You can also remove the glass bed and print directly on the bed beneath it. In the box, we also get this sheet that you can stick over the bed, and that will also solve this problem. But my bed is already leveled for the glass height. So I decided to put a DST tape right in the center of the glass to save time. If you face this problem, you can also use a glue stick or just print on the surface beneath the glass. Putting the DST tape worked perfectly, and we are now finally printing. Everything seems good so far. You can also pause a print at any time from here. The bar over here shows the progress of your print. We are at 1% right now, 99% more to go. This pig will take around 4 hours to print. I will press resume and wait for the machine to finish printing. I also decided to print the other two models that came in the card to show you how all the final printed models look. I can spend hours just looking at it print. It's working smoothly and is hardly making any noise, which is a good thing if you're looking to set this up in your office. A big thumbs up from my side to ANet for making a machine so simple and user-friendly. I am glad it was shipped semi-assembled, and that saved a lot of time. I went from unboxing to printing in under 20 minutes. As you can see, this is about to finish. The bar over here shows 82% complete. I think this will take another half an hour to finish printing. And here we have it, the first model freshly printed right in front of you. Every model that is printed prints with a support structure like this at the bottom. Wait, let me just remove it and show it to you. So here you can see the support structure here at the bottom. This can be removed. I'm going to quickly remove it right now. Once the support structure is removed, all we have to do now is sand it and fine-tune all the hair-like structures that is coming out. I must say this has come quite fine and it doesn't have many imperfections, but whatever imperfections you see, you can rub it off with the sandpaper, which I'm going to do right now. Once this is done, and here we have it, the tiny piggy bank ready. I must show you how fine this came out. I am really, really impressed with the quality of this print. Look at the texture, it's super fine. I also have the other two models that we printed using this machine. Look at the texture on this one. It's super smooth. And here we have it, all the three models together that we printed using this printer. The average print time for each of these models were around 4 hours. I had a great time printing with this machine, and I think it is a great tool to have for designers or anybody who enjoys creating as a hobby. If you are interested to know more details about this printer, I'm going to put all the links in the description for you to check it out. That is all for now. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please don't forget to hit like and share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching. See you next week.